28 male, think my girlfriend 26 female of 4 years is going to leave me for her dying ex-boyfriend and first love. Following your messages, I have not been the same person since. It happened that I was using her old iPad for work, and her Facebook account was still connected to it. I was ready to write her using my messenger apps since I had left my phone at home, but I saw she had received messages from her ex-boyfriend and decided to back out. Let's call him Andre for the time being. Her and Andre had been together for 2 years at the time of writing. Their first love was each other, and she never told me what happened between them. While on a family trip in California with my parents, I happened to run see her a year and a half after they separated. I didn't know much about him other than the fact that they were in a relationship throughout high school and college. When I first met her, we hit it off straight away. She showed me around Los Angeles and didn't seem to mind that I was residing in Australia. In order to move her to another country, we had to be in a long-distance relationship for a year until I had saved up enough money. Aside from that, it took me months to find a job in Los Angeles that would allow me to be financially secure when I first came to the city. We're still going strong 3 years after we first started. As a result, I reasoned. When I clicked on their chat, I saw the kiss and love emoticons right away and was intrigued. It was at that point that I realized what was going on. I won't go into details, but one message stood out to me. She said that she would be leaving me for a few months to care for him. In the early stages of cancer, he feels he will die. He has cancer and believes he will die. In one of his messages to her, he inquired as to whether she would be interested in paying him a visit at his residence, and I'm very certain she did, since they both remarked how much fun they had together and how good it was to meet up with one another again. My discovery of the truth took place a week ago this week. She had no clue that I was aware of this, or that I took her old iPad out of its box and read their messages for 2 days without her knowledge. She has absolutely no idea what she is talking about. Despite the fact that she feels everything is okay between us, I went to uncontrollably for a long time and do bodily harm to myself. I don't have any friends in Los Angeles. They've all gone home and are content with their own lives. I don't want to talk about it with anybody, since it makes me feel sick to my stomach just thinking about it. When it comes down to it, I believe she never really cared for me, and I'm still trying to accept this. I'm at a loss on what to do in this situation. After writing my resignation letter for work, I notified my parents that I would be going home in the following several weeks, if not sooner. When I was very enraged, I performed both of these things. I just need guidance on how to continue. I don't want to talk about it with her since it's embarrassing. I can't even look her in the eyes since I'm in such a state of shock. Advice on what to do and how to deal with the issue would be much appreciated. Now that she's at work, I'm considering leaving while she's there. Update 1. I ultimately informed my girlfriend about the situation, and she is now my ex-girlfriend. Lots of things happened in a short period of time, many of which I had not imagined happening at all. As soon as she walked through the door of our apartment, I could tell she was going to cry. It hurt to see her in such a vulnerable state, since I didn't want to put her in that position. The fact that none of this was my fault was something I had to remind myself of all the time. When we finally sat down, there were many tears. In my mind, I anticipated to be angry and enraged, and to be shouting at her the whole time, but instead I was pleasantly surprised. I told her that I had seen the messages and explained how I had ended up going through their whole conversation with the texts in hand. She justified her actions by telling herself that she felt bad for him and that she didn't know how to say no to him since they had such a lengthy history together. Then I told her that we had a far longer family history than they did, and she seemed surprised. I was there for her when she was at her lowest point, and I assisted her in getting back on her feet. She admitted to having had more than 3 encounters with him in the past. I had a strong feeling it was going to happen, but hearing her confirm it was devastating. I couldn't stop myself from weeping excessively at that point. Because my thoughts were rushing, I can't recollect some details of what happened. Even now, this is still the case. I remember telling her that I was done, that whatever we were going through was over. The woman knelt in front of me and pleaded with me to forgive her. I don't think I'll ever be able to do so. People that deceive me anger me greatly. By that point, I'd finished packing around 1/3 of my possessions. I assume she is content with him if she can treat me like way. After I posted my first post, I received a message from a Redditor who gave me a place to stay. We were just about 15 minutes away from his place, which he picked me up and dropped me off at ours. Besides that, he'll aid me in selling a large number of my items that I won't be able to transport back home, as well as in assembling all of my possessions in my apartment. We both agreed that he would not be identified in this post. The fact that I shared myself with this group, rather than keeping it to myself, has made me happy. Please accept my thanks on behalf of everyone else who has given me a position. It's nearly 3 a.m., and I'm just as sad as I've always been, but I'm trying my best to get through it. I sent my resignation letter to my employer this morning. Everyone in my family is now aware of my predicament and has offered to provide a helping hand. I want to return to my hometown as soon as possible. Please get in touch with me if you happen to live in or near Chapel Hill, Australia. America, thank you for everything, but it's time to return home. Edit. It is not because I have been dumped that I am crying this time. Rather, it is because I have realized that there is a whole world out there that is really concerned about my well-being. I can't believe I ever contemplated self-harm as a means of escaping the misery I was experiencing. I am astounded and delighted to be a part of this community. In fact, Anthony and his wife, who happened to be the Redditor that helped me, have declared this to be the best thing that has ever happened to them. I may have lost a girlfriend and potential marriage, but I gained a swarm of new acquaintances, some of whom will become lifelong companions. I'm feeling better overall, save from one little inconvenience. It's still strange that she's no longer there, but what can a man do? She came to a choice, and I came to a decision. The next morning, I awakened to messages from her family begging me not to rush things and that she's 90 even makes mistakes just like the rest of us. Although it's a pity that I won't be able to see her family for a lengthy period of time, they were very lovely people. I thanked them and said that although I believe in second chances and acknowledged that everyone makes mistakes, cheating is a choice made by jerks and is never a mistake in my opinion. At roughly 5 a.m., I received an email from X. The email was much too long, and my eyes were aching from crying, so I deleted it soon after receiving it. I adore her, but I adore her much more. I'm well aware that it will take a long time for me to recover, but I guess I'll just have to wait. Final update. I wasn't able to sell everything in a short amount of time, but I was able to distribute it to others who were in desperate need of it. That in and of itself made me feel a whole lot better about my current circumstances. The number of goods I couldn't afford to bring back home was, including the television I bought for my ex, which she really enjoyed, the microwave, and my PlayStation 4. I'm now in Australia, and although things aren't going quite as planned, the situation I'm in is manageable for the time being. And to top it all off, my brother has been constantly assaulting me because of something foolish I said about a cancer patient when I was drinking. Because one of his closest friends died in a terrible manner. It was something along the lines of hope he dies in a dreadful manner that got him all worked up in the first place. To cut a long story short, I did not relocate to Brisbane to live with him and am now uninspired and jobless in Perth, where I am staying with my parents. I'm completely despondent and resentful of my ex, but there's nothing I can do about it other than to let it go and let it be.